Wake Up with Jim and Saab is exclusively on Spotify.
And if you want to start your own podcast, you can check out anchor.fm.
Welcome to the Wake Up with Jim and Saab podcast. Okay, I think among all episodes, if you've never listened to our podcast, I think this is the only one that you should listen to. We have the Vice President of the Philippines.
Yay!
Hi, Leni Jim and Saab.
Hi, VP.
Hi, VP. So we'd like to start. We just want to share, ako personally, we want to say na thank you for being our source of sanity during this time. Kasi we've been pushing in our podcast that we should be responsible with our mental health, but at the same time, continue educating ourselves about what's happening, the pandemic. And we just want to say, commend you and thank you because
you
and your team has been our source of information, comfort, and guidance during this time.
Yes. Ako, thank you din. Thank you, Jim and Saab. I told you even before that I have been watching your podcast already. And nakikita ko talaga how committed you are to helping. Hindi lang yung sa mental health, pero yung bringing about social change.
Oh,
wow. Yung sa akin, yung episodes nyo, pati yung IG ni Saab, I follow also. Sa amin din, source of lalo na yung mga bata, when your entries are about Pancho and Vito, sobrang good vibes. Sobrang good vibes. So, maraming salamat din. And Saab, thank you for volunteering to be one of our talents.
Yes,
yes. One of our videos for our initiatives with the education.
Oh, yes, of course. It's my pleasure, VP. So, I think, sana, you know, kayo talaga deserving kayo of good sleep. Sana masarap ang tulog nyo kagabi. And I wanted to ask, like, how many hours a night do you usually get to sleep?
Ako Saab, I average siguro mga 5 to 6 hours of sleep.
Okay.
Ayun yung aking average. There are times na when I get to sleep 7-8 hours, sobrang bonus na yon.
Yes.
And it's very, very seldom that I get that much sleep. Yeah. So, ako averaging 5 to 6 hours siguro.
Okay. I think I mean, I was thinking baka you didn't get enough sleep because of all the stuff that you're able to achieve in a day. So, speaking of which, I wanted to know if you can share, like, what is your morning routine? What time do you usually wake up? And are you as crazy about, like, a set routine as some people?
ako, sa akin, it changes. It was so different pre-pandemic. Mm-hmm. Because pre-pandemic, my second daughter, si Trisha, was still a student. Mm-hmm. She was an intern. So when she has duty na very early in the morning, I make sure that I wake up ahead of her so uh-huh. that I can take care of her baon, I can take care of all her needs.
Oh.
Pero during the pandemic, kasi parang so many things changed. Mm-hmm. I don't wake up as early as I used to. Kasi before, mga 5:30, I'm up. Mm-hmm. Pero ngayon, parang ano na, mas between 6:30 to 7 na akong gumigising kasi Trisha is out of school already. She's out of school already. She still does hospital duty pero not as intense as before. Tapos ano, I don't go to the office as early as I did before. Kasi before, I will be here mga 8 o'clock in the morning. So mga 6:30, nag-aayos na ako. Pero ngayon, especially from March last year until siguro mga December last year, I would go mga 10 o'clock in the morning kasi skeleton staff kami.
Mm.
But starting January this year, parang bumabalik na ng konti to normal. So I'm here ulit. Kanina, I was here at 8 o'clock. So between 8 and 9, I'm here already. So pag gising ko, I take care of the stuff for the kids. Hindi na nga kids kasi 20s, 30s na yung mga anak ko pero I still look at them as young children. Ngayon, I would have time to hear mass online. Nakakapagkape ako dati, nagkakape ako dito na sa opisina. Kasi lagi nagmamadali. So, during the pandemic, parang I'm not here in the office as long as I used to. Kasi dati, nakakalabas ako, madilim na. Uh-oh. Ngayon kasi we make it a point na parang between 5 and 6 in the evening, makauwi na yung mga tao. Kasi we shuttle them now.
Uh-oh.
Because may mahirap pa yung transport, diba? If I'm here late, hindi din sila nakaka-uwi kasi hinihintay nila ako. So ngayon, I try to get out of the office at least by 5 o'clock.
Okay, okay.
Question, VP. Kasi actually sa yung pod kids namin, they're, and you know, these kids, they're very addicted to different productivity hacks, productivity apps. Is there a certain app that you use that you think like, oh my gosh, kailangan ko talaga to?
Or do you still use a pen and notebook?
Pen and paper ka pa rin ba?
Oh, medyo low-tech ako eh. Ano ako, old school. Mas ano pa ako. Halimbawa, as far as schedules is concerned, parang I never get used to using the schedule app on my iPhone. Ano pa din ako, yung schedule ko, naka hard copy. When I edit, kasi they send me, halimbawa, speeches, halimbawa, messages. They send me drafts for me to edit. Hindi ko kaya mag-edit sa laptop, oo. Pero hindi ko kaya sa phone, hindi ko kaya sa tablet.
Yeah.
I can only edit using the laptop. Tapos when I have ideas, yung mga anak ko kasi nakikita ko na parang if they want to parang be reminded of things, nilalagay nila sa notes o sa alerts. I don't do that. Sa akin, I'm always with a pad and a pen. Even when I go to sleep. Kasi alam mo yun, I don't know if you've experienced it, pero pag gabi, what keeps me up is naiisip ko yung mga gagawin ko the next day.
Yeah.
So ako, nasa bedside ko na yung pad sa kapen. So whenever I remember something, sinusulat ko na kaagad. Kasi if I don't do that, hindi ako nakakatulog. Hindi ako nakakatulog kasi siguro I get worried na I might forget about that the following day.
That's a good tip. A way to empty your mind before para makatulog na.
Yes,
that's a good tip. I should do that. Kasi ang dami talagang so kayo, hindi kayo nag, you know what doom scrolling is?
Ano 'yun?
Yun yung parang pag matutulog ka na pero nasa stuck ka sa phone mo, nagsuscroll lang sa social media, tapos hindi ka makatulog.
ako sometimes, pero ngayon kasi I think this started only during the pandemic.
Okay.
Parang nasanay akong maglaro.
Okay.
Ang nilalaro ko, Sudoku.
Oh, I love Sudoku.
Parang before I sleep, naglalaro ako noon. Tapos yung mga anak ko kasi nagsosubscribe sila sa New York Times, Washington Post, The Economist. Nagsosubscribe sila doon. So nakikiangkas ako. And I only have time to do that in the evening. When I'm ready to go to sleep. Kasi pag nasa office na, wala na eh. Pag nasa office na, ang dami ng ginagawa. So pag uwi ko naman sa bahay, lalo na now that I go home much earlier than before, nagluluto ako.
Oh!
So yes. Parang 90% of the time, I'm the one who cooks dinner. Yung panganay ko, because she also works from home now, she's the one who cooks for lunch. Except if meron ako mga outside commitment, siya din yung nagluluto ng dinner.
Pero what are your usual dishes? Ano yung parang proud na proud ka na?
Ako alam mo, hindi ako mahusay magluto. Pero I benefit from a lot of YouTube recipes. Yung site ni Marjorie Barreto, si pinafollow namin yun kasi madali yung recipes eh. Meron din isang site na ang pangalan niya Simple, S-I-M-P-O-L. I also follow that.
So,
paminsan yung mga bata nagsasabing gusto namin tong kainin, so maghahanap ako ng recipe.
Parang
because of technology, everything is so easy already.
Yeah.
Parang housekeeping has been much easier than now than it was before.
Uh-oh.
Definitely. So, yun, I enjoy cooking for my children.
Oh, that's a good bonding experience that you get to cook with them. Aside from, go ahead.
And you have, ano din, I think for politicians like us, it is very important to have a private life.
Yes.
It's definitely very important to have a private life away from your political life.
Mm-mm.
Kasi I think that will help me, parang, kasi nakikita ko sa mga politiko, pag nakapasok, nahihirapan ang lumabas.
Mm-mm.
Alam mo yun? Parang they, siguro nahihirapan sila. And I didn't see that in my husband. Mm-mm. Parang for him, it was so easy to step back. So iniisip ko lang, siguro if I exert effort in trying to maintain parang as much normalcy in my life as possible, it would be easy for me also to make decisions, to step back if I need to. So ako, I try that. I try to parang do that as much as I can.
Mm-hmm.
Parang from the experience also of when my husband was still alive. Mm-hmm.